Hello friends, welcome to Tech Solution. Our today presentation on the history and scope of microbiology. What is microbe? Microbe is a word to describe an organism that are so small and tiny in nature. This microorganism includes virus, bacteria, protozoa, archaea, cyanobacteria, fungi, algae, etc. Now, if we consider them, the most of microorganisms are harmless in nature. 99% of microorganisms are good to us, whereas only 1% are bad in nature, that is known as pathogen. If we consider the cell structure of microbes, they are mainly classified into two groups. One is acellular, another one is cellular microbes. Now, what is acellular? Acellular means they don't have a particular cell structure. That means they don't have a cell membrane bound structure. They have only a genomic material that protected by protein coat. And they can live and reproduce only inside a host cell, example viruses. Now, if we consider cellular microbes, they are further classified into two groups. One is prokaryotic microorganism, another is eukaryotic microorganism. Prokaryotes are mostly unicellular in nature. Pro means before, that refers they are primitive organism of our environment. They have a naked genomic structure which is known as nuclei. They also don't have any membrane bound advanced organelles inside their cell. Examples, bacteria, archaea, etc. Now, what is eukaryotes? U means true, that refers they have a particular and true nuclear structure inside the cell, and they also have so many membrane bound organelles inside it. Now, these eukaryotic organisms may unicellular or multicellular. Protozoa is a good example of unicellular microorganism, whereas algae, fungi are the example of multicellular organisms. Here a new word arises, that is archaea. Archaea is a group of microorganisms that are similar to prokaryote by their size and simplicity of structure, and similar with eukaryotes with their molecular organization. In 1977, scientists Carl Hus and Fox first classified this group of microorganisms separately. With the lack of peptidoglycan in their cell wall structure, presence of some unusual coenzymes, and 16S rRNA gene sequencing results. This microorganism further classified into three categories. One is methanogen, two extreme halophilic organism, and three hyperthermophilic microbes. This group of microorganisms mainly found in hot spring, salt lake, volcano, and other extreme environments as well. What is microbiology? Microbiology is a discipline where we can gather the knowledge about microbes, which are usually less than 1 millimeter in diameter and not visible under naked eye. This microbiology includes some sub-discipline that are virology, bacteriology, protistology, mycology, parasitology, etc. How microbes relate with our lives? If we consider microbes, they are main causative agent of disease. Microorganisms also relate with agriculture, include in food industry and our environment. And here are some important disciplines where also microbiology includes, that is medicine, environment, food, biotechnology and research areas. Microbiology has a long and rich history with AIDS that initially centered in the causes of infectious disease, but now including practical application of science also. If we consider the time of discovery, that very good separated in four era, that is discovery era, transition era, golden era and modern era. Spontaneous generation is a term that first arises in our microbiological discovery era. Spontaneous generation is a hypothetical process by which living organisms develop from non-living matter. This was hypothesized that certain forms such as fleshes could arise from inanimate matter such as dust, or that maggots could arise from dead fleshes. This theory first comprehended by Aristotle in his book on the Earth Generation of Animal, that around 350 BC. In this book, Aristotle said non-living matter contained a vital heat that called pneuma, the concept of breath of life. This word further translated in anima, that means soul. He also said a combination of four elements believed to make up all lives, that is earth, air, fire and water. He suggested that animal and plants could arise from earth and liquid because there was vital heat within all air. There is air in water and there is water in earth. That means there is vital heat or soul present in everything. This spontaneous generation theory further supported by scientist John Needham by his boiled mutton broth experiment. Abiogenesis is a similar conceptual theory on origin of life, which demonstrate life has arisen from non-living matter such as simple organic or inorganic compound. In 1953, scientist H. C. Urey and Stanley Miller tested the operon-handling theory and successful to produce organic molecule from some of inorganic compound by his experiment. The experiment of these two scientists, known as the Miller-Urey experiment, where they combine warm water with the mixture of four gases, that is water vapor, methane, ammonia and molecular hydrogen, and create the atmosphere with electrical discharges. After 1 week, Miller and Urey found that simple organic molecules including amino acid had formed under the stimulated condition of early earth. These experiment proves that a simple organic molecule arises from inorganic compound. In earlier period, some Roman physician and Roman philosopher Lucretius believed that some invisible creature were responsible for disease. And then Francesco Stiuli first observed bees under microscope, which are responsible for foodborne disease. After that, a Dutch scientist, Antony van Leeuwenhoek,
made a careful observation of microscopic organism which named as animalcule, that means a tiny animal. Through his experiment, he was the first relatively determine their size and shape. Most of animalcules are now referred to as unicellular organisms, although he observed multicellular organisms in pond water. He was the first who document the microscopic observation of muscle fiber, bacteria, spermatozoa, red blood cell, and as well as blood flow in capillaries. He is commonly known as the father of microbiologist and one of the most first microscopist and microbiologist in world. When microorganisms were known to exist, most scientists believed that such simple life form could surely arise through spontaneous generation. During transition era, the main aspects were to solve the controversy over spontaneous generation, which includes experimentations mainly of Francisco Redi, John Needham, and Lazarus Palenzani. Among those scientists, Francisco Redi was an first Italian physician who suspect that the theory of spontaneous generation may be flawed, and he set up a simple experiment to prove it. He placed fresh meat into two different jars, one covered with muslin cloth and other left open. But after few days, the open jar contained maggot, while the cover container have no maggot spore. He sawed and proved that the maggot had to come from fly's egg, whereas spontaneous generation not proved. After that, John Needham probably support the theory of spontaneous generation. He proposed that tiny organisms, animalcules, that arises spontaneously in his mutton broth. He covered the flask with cork, which was previously done by scientist Redi. After Needham experiments, an Italian naturalist Lazzaro Spallangeni attempt another experiment where he boiled beef broth from a long period of time and pour into a container from where he removed the entire air and sealed the container. After incubation period, he observed that no microbial growth occurred inside the container. By his experiment, he proved that microbes or animalcules may present in air. The golden age of microbiology begins with the work of Louis Pasteur and Robert Koch, who had their own research institute. More important, there was an acceptance of their work by the scientific community throughout the world and a willingness to continue and expand the work. During this period, we see the real beginning of microbiology as a discipline of biology. The concept of spontaneous generation was finally put to rest by the French chemist Louis Pasteur in an inspired set of experiment involving a goose neck or S-shaped flask. The neck he designed so that fresh air could not reach the flask. In 1859, Louis Pasteur designed an experiment with three different types of flask, in which the broth was boiled in various flasks for 1 hour to sterilize and allow it cool for incubation period. In first case, he boiled broth in a flask with a straight neck and left it exposed to air for microorganisms' growth. In second case, he boiled the broth inside the flask, which are already plugged with cotton, and keep it for incubation. And in third case, he boiled the broth in gooseneck flask and keep it for incubation. After incubation period, he observed that the open neck flask get contaminated with microorganisms, and the cotton plug flask and gooseneck flask broth are still sterilized. In case of S neck flask, it trap the dust particle that present in air by preventing them to reach inside the broth. Pasteur shows that he could allow air to get into the flask but not the particle that present in air. By his experiment, Pasteur proved that the microbes or animalcule arises inside the flask are present within air and are not spontaneously generated. Now, here is a slide with contribution of Louis Pasteur. Pasteur had first disproved spontaneous generation theory by his experiment with swine neck or goose neck flask with broth. In 1897, Pasteur suggested that mild heating at approx 62 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes rather than boiling was enough to destroy undesirable microorganisms from any liquid, which is further known as pasteurization process. Pasteur also postulated the germ theory of disease, which stated that microorganisms are the causes of infectious disease. He also demonstrated that anthrax was caused by bacteria, and he further produced the vaccination for his disease. He also coined the term microbiology, aerobic, anaerobic in front of biological discipline. Around the same time that Pasteur was doing his experiment, a German physician, Robert Koch, was also working on finding the cause of some nasty animal disease, that is anthrax and tuberculosis. He gave the first direct demonstration of the role of bacteria in causing disease. He was a first who isolated anthrax bacillus in 1876. He preferred the technique of isolating bacteria in pure culture. He also introduced the use of solid culture media in 1881 by using gelatin as a solidifying agent. In 1882, he discovered Mycobacterium tuberculosis. He proposed cause postulation, which are published in 1884 and are the cornerstone of germ theory of disease, and are still in use today to prove the etiology of an infectious disease. Now I am going to demonstrate the cause postulation respectively. In postulate 1, he said that the same microorganisms are present in every case of disease, and in postulate 2, he tried to isolate in pure form of microorganism from diseased animal tissue. Postulate 3, he tried to inoculate a pure cultured microorganism into a healthy animal for the production of disease. And in postulate 4, the identical microorganism are isolated and recultivated from the tissue specimen of experimental animal. Now, here are some experimental information by which Koch postulates his theory. Scientist Robert Koch developed a staining technique to examine the tuberculosis cell from identified diseased tissue, from which he postulated that the microorganism must be present in every case of disease.
absent in healthy individual. After that, he prepared a blood serum coagulated culture plate to isolate Mycobacterium tuberculosis in a pure form. After that, Koch injected the pure cultured Mycobacterium tuberculosis into a healthy guinea pig body, which further died of the disease tuberculosis. This experiment proved that the microorganism tuberculosis are causative agent for tuberculosis disease. And then he isolated the bacteria further identification purpose.
Before accepted the germ theory in 19th century, it is termed as miasma theory, which refers the pollution or bad air presence in environment. Miasma theory demonstrates that the disease originated from decomposition of organic matter and produced harmful vapor harboring disease causative agent. Now, what is germ theory? In 19th century, the French chemist and microbiologist Louis Pasteur, the English surgeon Joseph Lister, and German physician Robert Koch are given much more credit for development and acceptance of germ theory. This germ theory stated that the disease are caused by the invasion of microorganisms inside body, which are so small in size.
Once scientists knew that the microorganisms are the causative agent of disease formation, there are so many development arises in medicine, surgery and vaccination discipline.
First, Edward Jenner used a vaccination procedure to protect smallpox disease, and then John Tyndall demonstrated a heat resistant theory to protect bacterial endospore formation. After that, John Lister also developed a surgical prevention method by spray phenolic reagent and also tried to decrease the number of post-operative infections. Then, scientist Ignaz stated that childbed fever caused by streptococcal infection. And scientist Richard discovered the petri dish to solidify the microbial culture media. Alexander Fleming discovered the penicillin from Penicillium notatum that destroy pathogenic bacteria. Now, this is a slide that show you the line of discovery with discovery era, transition era and golden era. Now, this is a slide of modern era after 19th century, where diphtheria, malaria, TB antitox, phagocytosis, penicillin, structure of DNA, genetic code, prion, genetic regulation of organ development and cell death are discovered by following and respective scientists. Now come to the point on area and scope of microbiology. If we consider the area of microbiology, that has a various and huge field with it. That is, microbiological study based on the organism basis includes virology, bacteriology, mycology, protozoology, etc. Virology refers the study of viruses, bacteriology refers the study of bacteria, mycology refers the study of fungi, and protozoology refers the study of protozoa. Now, if we consider the pure microbiological study that includes microbial morphology, microbial cytology, microbial ecology, microbial genetics, microbial taxonomy, microbial metabolism, and molecular biology. The applied basis of microbiology overlap the various other degree of biology like medical microbiology, pharmaceutical microbiology, food microbiology, epidemiology, agricultural microbiology, environmental microbiology and immunology. The scope of microbiology is huge because of the involvement of microbiology in various fields such as pharmacy, medicine, clinical research, agriculture, dairy industry, water industry, nanotechnology and chemical technology, etc. After completing microbiological BSc study and MSc study, there are some options by which you can develop your career and knowledge skills.